students, in the last video we have learned how to add and subtract the algebraic expressions. That is, basically we have learned about addition and subtraction of the algebraic expressions. Now in today's video we are going to learn regarding the remaining two operations on the algebraic expressions, that is multiplication and division. You already know about this, that multiplication is nothing but the repeated addition and the division is nothing but the repeated subtraction. Now, whenever we consider the multiplication and the division of the algebraic expressions, already we have discussed regarding the rules that we have to follow whenever we are multiplying and dividing the algebraic expressions. Now, with respect to the same thing, I want you all to recollect those rules and connect it with the examples that we are going to observe now. So now in multiplication and division, already you are aware of the fact that there is nothing called as multiplication or division of like and unlike terms here, because you know that the multiplication and division of algebraic expressions will result in a single term being formed. So now let's consider the examples to understand this multiplication and division of algebraic expressions better. So the first example that I have considered here is multiply 2a square and 4a. So both are monomials here. I am multiplying one monomial by the other monomial here. Now coming to the solution part of it, the first very basic rules of multiplication of algebraic expressions states that the numerical coefficient of the two algebraic expressions have to be multiplied and the power on the variable should always be added. Let us follow those steps to get the answer now. So 2 into 4 will give me 8. So 2 and 4 are the numerical coefficients of the monomials here. So 2 into 4 is 8. A square into A will give me A cube. How? Because the power on A square is 2 and the power on A is 1. So 2 plus 1 will give me 3. That is how I obtain the solution for this problem as 8A cube. Now let's consider another example here, wherein I have taken two terms here, both are binomials if you observe. So I have enclosed the terms within brackets, stating that I am multiplying these two. You can see here that in between the two brackets, that is the bracket of the first algebraic expression and the second algebraic expression, you don't find any symbol here. That means we are multiplying it. Now the easiest way of finding a solution for this here is, what am I going to do here is, I am going to retain one of the algebraic expression as it is and I am going to split the other algebraic expression into two parts and then multiply. Let us see how we can obtain the solution. So I have retained 2x cube y plus 4xy square as it is in this example. 2x cube y plus 4xy square into first term of the first algebraic expression, that is into 4x cube plus 2x cube y plus 4xy square into second term of the first algebraic expression, which is minus 2xy square. So when I try to multiply here, you can see 2 4s are 8. X cube into x cube will give me x to the power of 6 and y remains as it is because that's the only one term that is remaining here. Plus 4 4s are 16. X into x cube will give me x to the power of 4 into y square as it is. Now coming to the second part of it. So you see here we are multiplying the whole algebraic expression by minus 2xy square here. So plus into minus will give me minus. 2 2s are 4, and x into x cube is x to the power of 4. Y square into y is y cube minus. Once again, 4 2s are 8. So x into x will give me x square. Y square into y square will give me y to the power of 4. That is how we obtain the solution. Now let's consider another example here, wherein I have taken two binomials once again, x by 2 plus x square into x cube by 3 plus 5. We are going to follow the same procedure as we have followed in the last problem. So I am going to keep x by 2 plus x square as it is, and I am going to split the other term in other algebraic expression into two terms. So let's start with the solution now. X by 2 plus x square into first term of the second algebraic expression, which is x cube by 3 plus x by 2 plus x square into second term of the second algebraic expression, which is 5. So now x into x cube will give me x to the power of 4 in the numerator. In the denominator, it is 2 3s are 6, which I have obtained, plus x cube into x square will give me x to the power of 5 by 3, which is in the denominator, plus 5 into x by 2 will give me 5x by 2, plus 5 into x square will give me 5x square. So let's consider one more problem. Here we are considering this problem with respect to division of the algebraic expression here. So the sum is divide 4p square q cube r by 2p cube q square. So here I have split 4p square q cube r into 4 into p into q into q into r, divided by, I have split 2p cube q square as 2 into p into p into p into q into q. So this is how I have split the given terms into. So you can see here that 2 1s are is 2 and 2 2s are 4 here in the numerator. So 2 will remain in the numerator because 4 by 2 is 2. And 1p will get cancelled with one more p here. Then 1p in the numerator will get cancelled with one more p in the denominator. So both the p's are gone in the numerator now. There is no p term in the numerator. Now coming to q term, you have 1q getting cancelled with one more q in the denominator. You have the second q in the numerator getting cancelled with q in the denominator, and that is how we are left out with q and r in the numerator. Now in the denominator you are left out with 1p. So the solution here is 2qr by p, which is the same as 2rq by p. They both are one and the same here. Now let's examine another example wherein x square plus 3x minus 4 is a trinomial. Actually I am dividing the trinomial by a binomial here. 2x minus 3 is a binomial. So when I consider x square by 2x, it is x will remain in the numerator. By 2 as it is, it will remain in the denominator. Now minus 3 is in the denominator and plus 3x is in the numerator. So when I divide plus 3x by minus 3 in the denominator, it is nothing but getting cancelled with each other. Plus divided by minus is minus. So it is minus x minus 4, which is in the numerator. It remains as it is because it is neither divisible by 3 or minus 3 here. So we will consider the assignment questions with respect to multiplication and division of algebraic expressions. The first assignment question would be, multiply 4x to the power of 5 minus 3x plus 7 into 2x plus 5. Now the second assignment question would be, multiply 3y cube plus 4y minus 10 by 3y to the power of 6. Now the third assignment question is, multiply 3 by x cube plus 4x into 1 by 2x square minus 5x. Next, divide 4a square plus 2a by 8a. Next, divide m cube plus 7m square minus 2 by 3m minus 4. Thank you very much, dear students.